so to Bethlehem one starry night. The God of glory sent his son, Messiah, Savior, promise one. The prophets told that he would send the perfect lamb to save our land. And then an angel came to say, the time has come for the world to know his name.
He shall be called Wonderful Counselor.
Christmas, the season of hope, the story of our redemption. Even though centuries have passed since a radiant star first pointed the way to a makeshift sanctuary in Bethlehem, the celebration of Christmas continues to capture the hearts of believers around the world. Each year, the familiar refrain of Luke's second chapter once again evokes images of angels and shepherds and kings bearing gifts. Yet even as our traditions continue to evolve, the one constant remains. It's the reason for this season. The Father's one and only Son, God incarnate, the great I Am, wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. Long before the angel of the Lord disrupted the still of a shepherd's night with the announcement of a Savior, God was already preparing the hearts of the people who were living in darkness. Help was on the way. A Redeemer would come.
Wonderful Counselor, that's who you are.
For us to try to comprehend the vastness of God's mercy would be as futile as trying to count the stars in the sky. For there is no beginning, and there could be no end. Love without measure revealed to us through the very nature of a father's heart. When he saw his creation broken and hurting, it was not within him to turn his heart away. When love required the ultimate sacrifice, he was more than willing. After all, what else would a father do?
In a world where chaos rules and hope does not exist, the father's heart is broken as he sees. Pain his children struggle through, the sleepless nights we face. So in his love he creates.
For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Powerful words spoken by the Creator, discerned by the prophets, and manifest in the faithfulness of a young Jewish girl. These words would find their voice once again before an audience of shepherds as the midnight sky exploded with the angels' proclamation that Christ the Savior was born. Scripture tells us they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger.
Unto
Down through time, seekers have continued to come, searching for a Savior from every corner of life. The rich and the poor, the mighty and the humble, the wanderer and the worshiper, all brought together by one whose name is above every name. In the days of the prophets, the world languished in despair. Misguided rulers and false teachings only intensified the cries for a deliverer to come, bringing peace, not just a temporary calm, but a true, lasting peace. In the centuries that have passed, on the surface, it would seem that very little has changed. We are still a people who long for our God. Though Jesus is here now with us, not all the world bows to acknowledge him. But believers, take heart. The day is coming when he will fully reign and rule over all.
In a world where words like bullets fly, we turn our faces to the sky, we're watching, waiting. These times it seems just parents strive are such a part of daily life. We're longing, aching,
The baby born in the manger is the Prince of Peace. One day there'll be no more strife, no more grief, no more war, for the Prince of Peace will come again. Amen. And until then, we want to thank God for those who keep the peace, who keep us safe in this evil world in which we live. And I want to say to every veteran, all active military, every law enforcement officer here today, we respect you, we honor you, and we thank you for risking your lives to keep us safe. Every song in this cantata has been about one of the names the Bible assigns to Jesus. They describe who he is and what he does. We have heard him called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace, the Messiah, the Savior, Emmanuel, Blessed Redeemer. He's all of these and more. The next song tells us his given earthly name in Matthew's account of the Nativity. The angel declares to Joseph, "Thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins." It is his name given because he came to save lost humanity. This is his special role. He saves from the guilt of sin by his atoning blood. He saves from the dominion of sin through the sanctifying Spirit. He will one day save from the consequences of sin by changing this mortal into immortality and this corruptible into incorruption at his coming. He is Jesus. He is the Savior. You see, the baby born in a manger was God, and he came for a purpose. We tend to romanticize the nativity, and it is sweet. You could call it even cute. But we must remember the cute little baby would one day grow up to die on a cross in order to be our Savior. He came to save. He came to deliver. He came to set free. This next song talks about the hope we have in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. And if we will believe, he, Jesus, can break every chain.
You're my refuge when I'm weary. You're the shelter for my
Jesus, my
I hear those chains falling. There's power in the name of Jesus. Paul said, God has highly exalted him and given him a name that's above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. Yes, there is power in the name of Jesus. And if you're here and in need of deliverance, if you're in need of salvation, no matter the bondage, no matter the addiction, no matter what it is that has a hold in your life, Jesus can break every chain. Peter said, neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. There's no other name, no other man. No one else that can save you. No other name, no other one can break the chains. But there is power in the name of this man named Jesus. He can break every chain, the chains of sin, the chains of alcohol, the chains of drug addiction, the chain of bitterness, depression, pride, whatever it may be. He can break that chain, which is why he came. If you have need of deliverance from sin, you can be free, because that baby born in a manger died on a cross and shed his blood in order that you might be saved and every chain broken. So how is it that one gets saved? Well, it's really quite simple. We make it difficult, but it's not according to the Bible. It's really as simple as, I like to say, as simple as the ABCs. You see, number one, A, acknowledge that you need a Savior. Jesus said, they that are whole don't need a physician, so you have to recognize that you're a sinner and you need a Savior. So the first step is A, just acknowledge that you need Christ. We've all sinned, every one of us, and come short of the glory of God, no matter how moral we may be. None of us measure up. Our righteousness is as filthy rags in the sight of God. Then there's B, believe. But what is it we believe? Well, we believe that baby born in a manger who died on a cross did so to save you, to forgive you of your sins. So we believe that he paid our sin debt on the cross. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And then see, call upon his name, confessing your need, confessing your sin. Romans 10:13 says, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Whosoever, that means you, that means me. Whosoever shall call upon his name. So this morning, if you need a Savior, he already came. He died to forgive you, to save you. And you can be saved by acknowledging your need and believing in what he did for you. Just call. Just call today.
The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. His name is Jesus. He is our hope. He is our deliverer. He is our Savior. There is no other name in heaven given to men by which we must be saved. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill toward men.
This is the love of heaven through all eternity. Before the dawn of Eden, he knew our deepest need. The King of all compassion, giver of all grace, sent his Son from glory to an humble place.
Savior, Savior, our deliverer has come. Savior, Savior, God has given us his Son. And he will bear our burdens and take our sin and shame. Savior, Savior, Jesus is his name. Yea, Lord, we greet thee on this happy morning. Jesus, to thee be all.
Well, they did a great job, didn't they?